filled my cup low. I lift it up low. Come and quench this thirsty in my soul. Rather than feed me till I want no more. Fill it up, Lord, fill it up and make me whole.
Personally, he was there when Billy Graham was dying, and have 5,000 member congregation on Sundays, and he got to the point in his spiritual development where he could no longer tell people that they were going to hell. He stopped preaching about going to hell. He stopped preaching about the devil, and they all left. They kicked him out. We want our devil back. What are you doing? Today he says he preaches the gospel of inclusion, which is what we preach here at Unity. If you look at our core values, inclusive is one of our cherished core values here, because we truly believe that everybody is a child of God. Everybody is beloved of God. Everybody was born as an original blessing. You were not born into original sin. Let that land with you. You were not born into original sin. You do not need someone to save you from yourself. You don't need Jesus to save you from God because God is mad at you. That doesn't make any sense. Do you believe in a God that wants to burn you in hell for eternity? How many people have children out here? Like, if your child did something you didn't like, would you throw them out in front of a car? No. You might try to guide them and direct them and save them, you know, but you're not going to torture them and punish them. So if how can we believe in a God that's going to do that? Because I can't, and I don't. So Carlton, Bishop Carlton, calls himself a metacostal. a metaphysical Pentecostal. A metacostal. And he had the nerve to call me that. I don't know where he gets that from. Like, everybody thinks that I grew up Pentecostal, and I didn't. I grew up in a church where they told you to sit down, shut up, and do what you're told. Like, there wasn't any music in the church at all. We didn't even have a piano. Somebody read some obscure verse somewhere in the Old Testament back there that said, lift your voice up to God, and the instruments will take away from the sound of your voice. So we're not going to have any. So I will never forget, you know, I got baptized, I did the whole thing, and it didn't take, obviously. And so they wanted me to lead the singing on Sunday morning. So I get up there in my 12-year-old squeaky voice, and I try to, like, get everybody going. Of course, I'm up there, you know. And then one of the deacons stood up and got everybody going. The church was just like, ugh, it was just wrong. Felt bad. It didn't feel good. So our intention when we come here is to create a safe and loving container. A nurturing environment where everybody here has the opportunity to experience God. And you don't need me or Jesus or your mama to go between you and God. You don't need your grandmother's God. You have your own personal relationship with God. It is totally yours. It was made for you. It's your own doorway into the Spirit. It was designed personally for you because you are a unique, individualized expression of one love, one mind, and one heart. And you can access that directly at any time. The song that I sang, I love the feeling that it gives me. Fill my cup, Lord. Here I am. I'm an open vessel. I am ready to be filled. Use me. Show me what to do. Fill me up with your Spirit. I love the way that feels when I sing it. Now that comes from a story in the New Testament, in the book of John, where Jesus is going from Judea to Galilee, and he takes a shortcut through Samaria. Now, at that time, Samaria was not a place that Jewish people wanted to go. The Jews considered the Samaritans to be unclean. You know the story about the Good Samaritan. Right? Okay, well, Jesus is taking a shortcut through a place that he's not supposed to go, and then he sits down at a well and starts talking to a woman who he's not supposed to talk to, a Samaritan woman, oh my God, and he starts telling her about, well, you know, this well may run dry, but the water that I give you to drink will never run dry. There's a well of living water that is within you that will never run out. Charles Fillmore, one of the Unity co-founders, called it an inexhaustible resource of spirit that is equal to every demand. that is able to be shaped and formed by our thoughts and feelings into manifestation, so that we may bring forth the glory of God into this world. You know, while we were up there, Carlton is coming into new thought. Carlton Pearson is coming into new thought as somebody from the outside looking in. And he told us things like, well, you know, you've got the mind, you got that down, you got the divine mind part down, but the heart part is a little missing sometimes. It's like you need some life in your church. I'm like, well, you need to come to Savannah and see what we got going down there, you know? He said, well, you know, the message that we have in New Thought is so powerful, it's so transformative, it's so life-changing, it's so what the world needs right now, but y'all need to quit hiding. He said, you need to expose yourself. So I decided to come back to Savannah and expose myself. That's what we're all in here. Like, they used to call unity the spiritual world's best kept secret. Okay, I'm tired of keeping the secret. We need to come out of the closet. Hello, somebody say something to me. About truth. You know the Pentecostals influence Congress. Yeah. Hello! We need to let people know what we're about here. So part of the expansiveness that I'm seeing for this place is that we're expanding not only in consciousness, but we're expanding in our reach. I see Josh over there has got us on Periscope this morning. Praise Jesus. We got Stephen back there. He records us and puts us on YouTube. You know, if you're on Facebook, share our talks, share our messages with your friends. Just like it. People look at what you like on Facebook. Share something with somebody. How many people in this room have had their lives changed by unity? A good number of us. Okay, then why do you want to keep that to yourself? Hello? Tell somebody about it. Invite somebody to church. Give somebody a unity book, and if you do, keep doing it. And it's not because we want to make a lot of money here, we want to fill all the seats, which would be bad, that's a byproduct of sharing the message that everybody is loved, and everybody is loved, and nobody's going to hell. I don't care what your mama told you. I don't care what your daddy told you. I don't care what the preacher said. You're not going to hell. Just put that over here. Okay, there is no eternal torture chamber that God has designed especially for you. God has designed a life of abundance for you. Jesus said, I came so that you may have life and have it abundantly. Wouldn't you like to have some of that living water that never runs dry? I do. So think about the daily word that we read today about going deep. Dig your well deep. What is your well? See, these are my questions that I have. What is your well? What is your thing that makes you feel filled up with the Holy Spirit? What is the thing that when you're doing it, you don't think about nothing else but what you're doing? You're there, present. Do that. Do that. That's what you're born to do. Do what makes you come alive. Howard Thurman tells us this. Don't try to figure out what the world needs. Decide what makes you come alive, and then go do that. Because the world needs people who have come alive. Yep. Amen. 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 God needs rock stars. We are here to know God and to show God. To know God and to show God. So how do we know God? How do we know God? We spend time in retreat. We go into nature as part of the retreat. There's lots of woods and stuff and things to do up there. Before everybody gets there, the ministers show up a day early. So it was Tuesday afternoon. All the people started coming in that evening. And I took a walk up the mountain. It's a couple of miles. It's pretty steep in a couple of places. But once you get up there, there's this gorgeous flat rock that I laid down on. And I could see the whole valley. Stephen was there last year, and he took some pictures. So I'm laying there on the rock, and I'm thinking about a problem that I have that I need to work on when I get back home. And suddenly it occurred to me, right, I caught myself. Like, why are you thinking this? Is there anything that you can do to change this right now? No, there isn't. And just let it go. Just let it go. This is a new practice I have. I talk to myself. I catch myself thinking about a problem in my life. And then I go, is there anything you can do about it right now in this moment? And if there is, then I do it to the best of my ability. And most of the time, there isn't. And then I drop it. Jesus told us in the Sermon on the Mount, he says, can you add 1 second to your life by worry? No, you cannot. So I let go of that. I changed my thought. Think about this. Have you ever tried not to not think about something? Can't do it, right? We have to get a new thought. Replace the old thought. So I'm laying on the rock. I'm thinking about something I don't want to think about. Man, I got all kind of tools all around me. There's a lizard crawling up that tree over there. Think about that. And think about how the rock feels up against my back and my hands. And how Native American people I've seen before will sit on the ground and draw strength from the earth. And I felt that strength of being on top of that mountain and looking at it and thinking about, wow, that sky is really blue. It looks really far off. The tree looks really close. It's like there's a movie of clouds playing behind the trees, and the sun started to come out through these trees over here, and there was, and I started having this mystical experience, and it's all because I changed my thinking. I started focusing on what was right there in front of me instead of what was going on in my mind about what I had to do when I got back. I got a new thought. I changed my thinking. I became present in what's going on. And so that's what we want to do here on Sunday morning. We want to create this space so that we can know God, so that we can dig our well deep, so that we can come here every Sunday and deepen our experience of God through worship, through praise. And when I say worship, I don't mean like falling down on your knees, though. God doesn't need to be praised. That's for us. We want to express thanksgiving. We want to express praise. It's part of our nature to express. That's what we are. We're not human beings. We're not human doings. We're human expressions. We are spiritual beings. Let's have a spiritual experience. Let's stop having a human experience. Let's focus on the spirit part of ourselves and see what happens then. Right? I am a spiritual being having a spiritual experience right now here with you. I can feel the power of the Holy Spirit moving in this room this morning. Amen? Anybody else feel the presence of God in here this morning? Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Something is moving in and through this community. And if you're not getting it here, go to where you are getting it. We have not cornered the market on God. Okay? But if you are getting fed by what's going on here, get involved. Find something to do. Dig your well deep. You know, we're going out in service at the end of October. Go out with us. Go out and serve other people with us. There's lots of little projects we can do. You know, Becky's encouraging us. Go to Walmart. Buy a blanket. Bring it here. Put it in a bin. You know, serve somebody. Get involved. Take a class. My new class is starting on Thursday. Now let me tell you what. The last class that we took blew my mind. You know, a lot of classes that I teach, we have to sit and read the book in class because nobody will read the book until they come to class. And it's boring. It's in there. Okay, let's turn to page 35. Start reading. These people had been reading and practicing the material on their own. We didn't have time to read the book because we were so fired up about what was going on in class.
That's right.
Wow, hey, I've been using this. Look at what's happening in my life. I use this. Let me share it with you. So come and dive deep with us. It's an 8-week class. It starts on Thursdays, so what, 6:30 to 8:30. And on the last class, we do presentations and we eat. If you want to get Unity folks to do something, just give them something to eat. Right? We're having Kyle's thing next. It's next Sunday, right? October the 4th. Georgia Kyle, our music director, has wrote a book. He's expressing the glory of God through books. He's got like three more in his brain already. This is the first one. So he's going to share it with us, and he's going to do a workshop on solving the puzzles of life, a technique that he has come up with to help improve your life, and we're going to eat. So come to, there's plenty of stuff to get involved in here. And if there's something that you want to do as part of this community and we're not doing it, let us know. Because we'll start doing it. We want to get out in the community. We want to let people know what's going on in our church here. Because we are the light of the world. Amen?
Amen.
Not just us, but everybody. Now, do you know somebody that doesn't know they're the light of the world? Hello? Do you know somebody that's living in sin? And what I mean by that is they're living in error thinking. They're thinking that they're anything less than a beloved child of God. They're thinking maybe they're going to go to hell. They're thinking maybe that God doesn't love them. They're thinking maybe that they're not worthy of God's love. They're thinking maybe they don't deserve God's love. Just be the light. Show them. You don't have to drag them to church. Just be what you are in front of them. And it'll be so attractive. They're going to go, Peggy, how did this happen to you? How did you have cancer? And now you're like jumping around and leading your own thing. We have so many success stories here in our church of people that have had overcomings from practicing the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit. Dive deep into your well. What's your well? What is yours to do? Where do you get your spiritual food? Dive into it. Let the Holy Spirit take you and guide you and show you and grow you. Because I'm here to say that we are appointed, we are anointed, we are deputized and authorized to show the power of the Holy Spirit at work in the world. Amen?
Amen.
Let's take that into prayer now. Take that inside. All that energy we've been feeling this morning, it's inside of you. The life of God, the living water of truth is inside of you, and it wants to come out. Let that water flow out of you. Dive deep into your well, the well of goodness that is within you. We are so grateful to know that we can come together on Sunday morning and know God and show God. To feel God, to see God, to be God. And to release the power and presence of God into the universe. Just like a flower that opens its petals, releases its sweet aroma into the air. We open our hearts and our minds to give and serve and live and release the sweet smell of the Holy Spirit into the atmosphere. We're so grateful for this time together. We're so grateful for each other. We're so grateful for the teachers of New Thought that have shown us the way to live a life of abundance and glory and goodness. And we release our prayer now on the wings of love, and we allow it to do its perfect work in the name of love and under the authority of the Holy Spirit. And so it is. And so we let it do. Amen.
There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place. Sweet expressions on each face. How sweet it is to be alive.